about minus 20. The wind is just blowing about 70 kilometers an hour. I seen Jeff out there shoveling so you wouldn't get buried in a snowdrift. So I made some coffee. I'm going to bring some coffee. There's Dave and Holly there. They're William's parents. William is a guy that I had done a little brief interview with. He's an artist. Quite a talented one too. He's putting on my mitts. So cold out there. So. Do this. Flip this around. Thunderbay, Ontario, 2022, December the 22nd today, just before Christmas.
When we pay our grocery bill, we just feel like making our will. Tell me, how can a poor man stand such times and live?
Oh, yeah. How much snow is coming in there?
We could take two kids and buy a dandy shirt. Now we pay $3 or more, maybe get a shirt that another man wore. Tell me, how can a poor man stand such time than live? Well, I used to trade with a man by the name of Gray. Flour was 50 cents for a 24 pound bay. Now it's a dollar and a half beside, just like skinning a flea for the hide. Tell me, how can a poor man stand such times and live? Oh, the schools of hell today ain't worth a cent, but they see to it that every child is sin. If we don't send every day, we have a heavy fine to pay. Tell me, how can a poor man stand such times and live?
Hello, my friend.
Hello.
You want to shelter yourself from the wind for a bit?
Yeah.
I got some coffee.
Hey?
I
got a pitcher.
You got a pitcher?
I got a pitcher.
Oh, what's that? Oh, your shovel?
So most likely just a hammer and a screw.
Okay, we're that's the other part of the shovel. You want me to fix that for you?
I can do it. I got tools. Finally, I was thinking of getting another one. A different.
So small, eh?
Well, it's durable. I like it the size.
Yeah.
Everybody was trying to steal it on me.
Really?
Yeah. Like right in front of Jeff, please.
Oh yeah, oh, no doubt.
Jeff.
Well. See, right here is like the perfect drift here that you want to put your Quincy in or something like that, right? Like, it'd be good if you could pile the snow up on everything and then you got insulation.
I just did a double layer today.
Not you did,
Charles did this one.
You did,
I did that one and the other one.
I know, it's just, I've seen it like this before. It's just like, so how many people are staying here on and off now? It's you?
My girlfriend comes as well. Dorothy's just here, chats with me, plays some cards, whatever.
Oh yeah.
So these are needles laying around on that side of the tent. I don't go on that side.
Okay.
I stay on my side.
Well, that's good. You don't want to get hit with a needle.
No.
Yeah. And they're in there now, right now. That's something else. It's amazing, really. So let's have some coffee. I got some. Yeah. I bought these because I for me to rent that coffee jug. Is it okay for me to come in? It's okay for me to come in here. You got lights in here?
I'll go in a second.
All right. Oh, this is nice in here.
Yes.
Oh, that works out good. What do you got for insulation on the bottom?
Nothing.
Holy fuck.
All we did was just put whatever you wanted.
Yeah, I know I got you all those boards there, those styrofoam boards. You've been using those, I hope. I can't see anything, my glasses all fogged up. Alright, so here, before I knock it over, you got two hands ready there? I get my gloves off. I ended up buying this so I could bring you guys coffee. You like a lot of sugar?
Yeah. I think I need it.
Yeah, I would think so.
Oh, there's nothing there. I'll put it on here. There, stop it.
Okay, I got sugar in here. And there's a bottom cup there. Oh yeah, here it is. I got some cream here too. So how this works is put your cup under there. I just made it. You got your cup there? Okay, just put it under that spout. You see the spout? I can't see anything because my glasses are all...
People keep leaving their stuff here. I don't know who it is.
Hey, they keep leaving their stuff?
Yeah, that's I don't know who it is.
Well, you're taking care of a lot of people. Hold this here and we'll put some coffee in there for you.
Okay.
Okay, ready?
Yeah. That's good.
That's good?
Oh, yeah.
All right, buddy. And you tell me how I make my coffee if you want stronger next time. There's the cream.
Me and Doris made candles all night one night.
You did, eh?
I think it was like 3 days ago. It was so cold. I like,
yeah.
I ran out of protein. Propane?
And I was like, sure, propane. I got a cookie for you.
All right. And I was like, propane just went out. She goes, yeah, I know. Want to make candles?
Yeah, yeah.
And I told her, I was like, no, I'm not interested. She goes, you're going to get cold. She just covered all the seals. And I covered all the seals.
Yeah. There's sugar in here.
So we sat in
the... Just pour it through the little hole, I think that will work. Be careful it doesn't pop the lid off though.
We sat in my tent there, she sat on her side. One, two, three.
There you go. Yeah, I didn't expect anybody to be here. They cleared out the other camp, eh?
Yeah,
Roger.
Roger passed away. He actually OD'd in here. I brought him back to life.
Roger passed away?
Yeah.
Roger's dead?
Yeah, we were going to the reserve. He says, Jeff, pack your stuff. We're going to the res.
Yeah, because I thought he was going to the...
They got him a house on the reserve, Squaw Bay.
Yeah, Squaw Bay, yeah.
And I told him, yeah, I'll go with you, man. 2 days, he says, 2 days, that's it. Or you want to go longer? It doesn't matter. I'll leave, man, I'll go with you.
And so, what was it? So fentanyl?
He was going like this, with, yeah. He's going just with a bag. Like,
yeah.
And I was like, what are you doing, bro? So I was doing my artwork, right?
Yeah.
Then I heard something on the tent go like this. I said, who's that? Usually someone answers me, right?
Yeah.
No answer. I said, Roger, did someone follow you here? He goes, no, I don't think so.
Oh, Roger was with you.
Yeah. So he took a hood off his thing, he fell over. I was giving him Narcan. He just threw it out of my hand. And
he died?
He didn't die there. I brought him back.
Oh, you did? Okay.
Yeah, he was breathing, he was coughing. Then I went across the street. I wanted to make sure that I didn't want that the overdose unannounced.
I
went to the shelter house and announced to some lady. She says, if you want to, you can call an ambulance. But he's breathing right now. He's in my tent. So she came here. She goes, oh, can you put him on my side? Yeah, he would breathe a little bit better.
Yeah, so in case they want to do that, in case he vomits.
His pupils are back already, back to normal. And paramedic came here. She looks, she says, paramedic is here. Want to give him another Narcan? I said, I gave him 3 already.
Yeah, yeah.
She says that. She says, she gave him another one. Okay. That was on her, right?
Right, yeah.
So a paramedic drags him out.
Of this tent or the other tent?
My tent right here.
Oh, the other one beside it.
And I was like, whoa, what's going on? I was like, his jacket is coming off. And his t-shirt is coming off. And it was like this windy.
Yeah, cold as hell.
And so you stay in your tent. And my cousin Holly came to check it out. She said, Jeff, your friend is dead.
Holly, that's over there.
Yeah, she said, your friend is dead. I said, no, he's not. He just left you alive. And I came out there. The guy, when he's doing CPR, he's doing it right here.
Yeah, you're right in the middle chest, yeah.
It was supposed to be on his chest.
No, it's good there. Yeah, it's in the middle chest.
And they had to wait.
And they don't do the mouth compressions anymore, that's done. Or the mouth breathing.
They had to wait 2 minutes before they do it again. Just for a machine to tell him that he's alive or not.
Right.
I had to do is just use the wrist thing. I counted every 5 seconds, I counted 2 heartbeats. So there's 120.
So he went to the hospital eventually.
He passed away on the road in the ambulance.
Right, but
they dragged him all the way there
to the hospital. Eventually.
Yeah.
Yeah, eventually he'd be there. That's fucked up. My friend died that same way. Well, not the same way, but you know.
Is there a spoon?
Hey, I got forks. That's all I got for this. This to stir it. Yeah. I wanted to come by more often. But
I was waiting.
I thought you guys are gone.
No, I was waiting. I want my interview.
Yeah, it was. Jeez, you know.
Yeah, when Roger passed, I guess I was sick. I didn't know that.
I didn't know Roger passed. I got his artwork too. It's too bad. It's horrible.
You want me to put up my thermal?
You know, go ahead. Yeah, for sure. I got 2 pots of coffee in here, and it's all for you. And I was gonna bring some over to. David and Holly there.
Yeah, I was watching their campsite and something happened. I don't know.
Something happened over there?
Yeah, I didn't really know. Something was stolen off them.
Oh, shit, eh? Well, everything is so bad. And you've been here almost every night.
Every night, yeah.
Every night you've been here. Sometimes I come here, you guys aren't here or what have you. But usually at night you're here, but then it gets a little bit...
This board here was caving in.
Yeah.
I fixed everything straight again.
Good.
There's no more snow coming in here.
Yeah.
And I got no batteries. These are the batteries I got left.
You need some double A's?
Both AAA and double A.
Okay. Oh, you're going into the other section there. It's all connected.
We're in
oh, that's good then. It works so good then. Well, you've gotten accustomed to the cold too.
I couldn't go off for like 5 days, 6 days. I went to the hospital. Apparently I had double pneumonia, and I had a hard time breathing. My lungs couldn't touch the cold air. So this is actually my first day out. Well, second day out.
From the hospital?
Well, it's not a thermal, it's a cup.
No, I said from the hospital? You were in the hospital for a bit?
Well, just a day, because they wanted to drain my lungs.
Yeah. Well, you sound like you're breathing good.
I'm breathing better, actually. I feel excellent. Thank you.
You trying to find your thermos? So I was able to get a few things done.
You remember those heaters?
Well, all the condensation from our breath gets up there, right? So. Unfortunately, there's no, and then that turns into icicles, and then that falls down back into your tent.
Yeah. Which I have to clean every day.
Well, yeah, I guess so. You have to, like, this is not definitely, I'm so ignorant. I'm just so ignorant. I did not know.
Charles slept in here a few nights. I told him, how was it? It's better when they blow the, all the air in there.
Yeah,
I use one of those floor mats.
Yeah.
Use it as a fan.
Yeah.
So he left all his blankets in his bed here. No, he was using a cot. It's in the corner.
So, you know, it's just like, you've been here for at least a month now.
Longer
now.
So I think it was October.
Yeah, when since I first came, eh?
Yeah.
Since
the salon.
Yeah, I didn't. I said, "Oh, geez, I gotta go down there and talk to you." I did not know this. I was hoping that you guys would have called me at least when you had a chance to. It's, you know, something. I ended up not seeing the mayor yet, but they notified me just the other day, and they said that they're gonna set something up for me in the new year to see them.
Yeah.
So.
That'll be sweet.
I hope so, and I'd like to give that invitation to you as well. But I just don't know how the meeting is about, really, totally. Because I love the aerial photography, too.
Yeah.
So what I was trying to do is I was trying to give them a present first, like, just so that they'd come get me in the door, right? So we'll see.
So, yeah, I've been working alone. Well, Charles is here, like, always here.
Right, okay, but he comes back every now and then. But he's got a place, he said, eh?
Yeah.
Humbug pill, dose of dope, and a great big bill.